God faithful, Paul, every day.
Chair proposal, Jesus is the way. Beach in the town of Cyprus, all the busy Salamis, Iconium or Paphos, to great Jerusalem. So be a Barnabas every day.
Somebody here is playing a trick on us, and I wanna know who it is.
Are you calling us a liars? Why would you do that? You are not liars.
No, 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 no. Nobody here is a liar. But Proconsul, Salamis, Iconium, since when did you start to sing that song like that?
Oh, ha, ha, ha. Calm down. I know the answer to that one. We started by singing the song like that because our theme of this month is
the missionary tours.
Correct. The missionary tour. Boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, today you and us are going to learn some missionary tour lessons. Say that with me, everybody.
Missionary tour lessons.
Yes, missionary tour lessons. Through the eyes of missionaries like who?
Like Paul, Barnabas, John Mark, and others.
Others here, children, are people like Bar Jesus, a.k.a. Elimas, and the wonderful proconsul, Sergius Paulus. But first, let's seek the Lord in prayer.
Let's pray. Dear God, dear Father, thank you for guiding us. Help us and help the children who are learning your word. And it is in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
So amazing people. Where shall we begin?
I have a suggestion. How about Antioch?
Isn't that where we were last Sabbath?
Ah, party spoiler. When you say it like that, you make it lose its oomph.
You are right, actually. That's where we were, and that's where this missionary journey began. You must remember, children, Antioch, the great and huge city, and where also the apostles and the disciples were first called?
Christians!
That's right. And in Antioch, the disciples did work for one whole year until it was time to leave. My question is, where shall we go from here?
Good question. Children, come with us. Let us follow the missionaries on this missionary tour. After much prayer and fasting, Paul, Barnabas, and John Mark, who did I say?
Paul, Barnabas, and John Mark.
Yes, the three got into a boat and they rowed and rowed and rowed until they got to a place called Cyprus.
Cyprus, boys and girls, was a small island in the great Mediterranean Sea. It didn't look beautiful, but most people there worshipped a mother of goddesses whom they called her Venus. Scary, right?
Yes, because God, our true Father, says we should not have any other gods beside him.
That did not scare the three disciples. At Salamis, they prayed about somebody whom you boys and girls know very well.
Would you like to guess who that is? I have hints. He's our friend, our brother, our king, and our risen savior.
Ah, that's Jesus Christ. But boys and girls, we have to move on now because the disciples have also moved.
Wow, that was fast. Where have they gone now?
They have stopped at many places to share the light of God's word.
But remember our song? They have stopped at a place called Paphos, still an island of Cyprus.
Hello there. We would like to see the proconsul.
I'm sorry. Who did you say you are again?
We are the disciples of the Most High God, and you are very excited to tell you about our Heavenly Father.
Whoa. Hold up. First of all, the only God around here is Venus. She speaks to me because I'm the wise man. Second of all, what makes you think you are welcome here? My friend, I beg, do you have an invitation?
Well, first of all, yes, we have an invitation. The proconsul asked to see us. And most of all, the God we worship is the only creator, the maker of all.
Ha ha ha, maker of all. Not so fast, Mr. Whoever you are. No one talks to the proconsul without talking to me first. What kind of lies do you wish to tell His Majesty?
Elymas!
Yes, my king.
Who are those I hear you talking to?
Nobody, my king. They have just lost shepherds on their way to God knows where. If I didn't know any better, I'll say they are thieves. They are carrying scrolls, which they claim to be scriptures. But don't worry, I'll get rid of them immediately.
But children, the Bible says that Elymas was an intelligent and wise person. He will not gonna let his wonderful opportunity pass him by. And so he said,
scrolls! Did you say scrolls? Bring them to me.
But my king, like I said, they could be thieves for all we know.
Spare me your wisdom, Elymas. Let them come.
Boys and girls, as you go through your missionary journey, you'll meet with people like Elymas. The devil will use them to stop you from teaching the word of God. Because if yes, the people will believe in God. But be faithful, like Paul, and stand firm, and God will do wondrous miracles through you. At this point, Paul looked into the eyes of Elymas and said,
you, Elymas, are a child of the devil. You are full of lies and tricks, but you cannot stop our God. For this reason, you will become blind for a period of time, unable to see the warmly innocent rising of the sun.
Oh my! I thought he was my wisest man, but clearly he is full of lies and deceit. Paul, I now see that your God is truly the one true God.
But boys and girls, this journey does not end here. I, John Mark, I'm particularly excited because we are going back into our boat to roll again. Let's go.
Roll, roll, roll your boat. Roll, roll, roll your boat.
Wait! Aren't we leaving someone? Where's Barnabas?
Let's go.
Roll, roll, roll your boat. Roll, roll, roll your boat. Gently down the stream. Gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 the gospel has to spread.
And here we are in Pamphylia. We have to go back to Antioch from here. Oops, where are the boys and girls?
Don't worry, they were in the boat just behind us. I think they are at the shore.
Listen, I tell all of you and the children something. The journey ahead is a little difficult. The highways are lonely and dangerous. Some days we will go hungry without food. We will walk long journeys and get tired. Some nights when nobody will welcome us to their homes, we will have no place to sleep.
But we, all of us, are like faithful shepherds searching for a lost sheep. We will not make ourselves comfortable until we have found them, the lost sheep. We must leave the tents of ease and press forward to the goal. But we can trust God, for His power alone can deliver us.
We walked and walked and walked. And as the 20th day came, I could tell our friend John Mark was getting tired. In fact, more than tired, he began to be disappointed and discouraged. At last, when he couldn't keep quiet no longer, he said,
I'm sorry, But somebody show me which way is to Jerusalem. I am going back to my mom's big, huge mansion.
That way, my dear cousin.
That way?
No, that way. I tell you what, boys and girls, John Mark did not come with us to Antioch to preach, but later he became a stronger and even better missionary.
And at Antioch, a city of many Jews, we preached about Jesus, our friend. We told them that he is our rock, our strong rock, the sure foundation, a living stone on whom we can build.
Yes, children, we told them that the strong rock suffered and died so that we all can be forgiven and be clean.
Yes, we told them that the strong rock is coming back to take us all home, where we will dwell with him forever. There we will have eternal life and live with Jesus forevermore.
And you know what's amazing? Is that everyone in the city told everyone in the city, who told everyone in the city, until the whole city heard the good news.
And so we all came together and sang.
So go out and preach the word
yesterday, today, all the time.
Go out and preach the word
yesterday.
Father God, thank you for the sermon, God. Help us to understand it, God. For it is in Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
Well, boys and girls, as we go through, the missionary tour gets even much more interesting as we go to guess where?
Iconium!
Children, go back to your boats and continue sailing. Welcome again next Sabbath. For now,